here once again. This is IPv4 summarization, all right? And it's going to be completely different when you're doing the IGRP summarization, when you put it into action, when you apply what you summarized, all right? It's different for EIGRP, OSPF, and BGP, okay? It's going to be different. But you need to know the concepts of summarization. So first of all, what is summarization? Well, as you can see here, okay, you have just simple, the first one's a simple one, right? You have three different networks. We're assuming default mask for is a CIDR 24 because it's a class C. So we're assuming the default mask for class C, okay? So we're assuming 24. That's where you see 1, 2, and 3. Now there's rules to summarization, okay? They have to be in contiguous order. They have to be, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, so forth, okay? They have to be an even number of networks, which is not, and you need to start with an even number, which this does not. All right, so it can work perfect. Maybe it should work perfectly if that's the case, all right? That nothing sneaks in, but you're gonna see what I mean in a second. Now, there's many ways to do summarization, but good Lord, do it this way. Put things in binary, that way you don't have to worry about anything else. It's quick and it's simple and it's easy, all right? Let me change colors. All right, so the first thing that I do, because you're not working with the first octave, which is 192.168. You're not working with that one, okay? This is where your focus is at right here. 1, 2, and 3, okay? 1, 2, and 3. So I'm gonna put, this is your third octave. 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1. What about the fourth octave last? What are you gonna do with that one? Listen, it's out there, it's off, it's zero. Just zero, okay? So what's one in binary? Let's change the color again, okay? I'm a colorful person. Ah, let's use green. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Can you see that? Barely, okay? So that's a one right here. Now one's on. 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. That's 2, okay? And then 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Because 2 plus 1 is 3. I mean, that's the hardest math that this thing gets. All right? So what do you do? Where do you draw the line? Because summarization is the opposite of subnetting, right? Subnetting, you're breaking it up into little segments. Summarization is bringing everything together as one. In the Microsoft world, it's called supernetting, okay? Which I know back in my day, they say don't supernet. That's the bad thing. You should do route summarization and then use that. Okay? So what do? We need to draw our line when we go left. And remember, this is the third octet. Okay? So from left to right, we're going to look at each column and we're going to say, okay, where are, they're not all zeros and they're not all ones. Uncommon bit values. Uncommon bit values. You can turn into a dance. So all zeros, all zeros, all zeros, all zeros, all zeros, all zeros. And look at that. Uncommon bit values, right? Because this is 0. This is 1. This is 1. That's where you bump into the first uncommon bit values, right? Oh, you can see this better. You actually just keep it black. Okay? So that's where you run into the first uncommon. So you already know your mask, all right? Your mask went from a 24, went from a CIDR 24, which is the default, to what? Because you got 8, I'll come this way, 8 bits, that's 24. Well, now you got this line here and your third octet. So it's no longer that, is it? You went this way. So now you got 8 bits, in the first octet, 8 bits. In the second octet, that's 16. Then you have 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So your new mask or CIDR, it's a 22. Did you see how I got that number? You do it again. We put the third octet into binary. Boom. We find out what 1, 2, and 3 is in binary. Lovely. Then we started looking from left to right in the third octet. Where is the uncommon bit values where there's a combination of zeros and ones? All right. So we went from left to right, and we saw it right here. We drew the line before that bit value 2. So we drew it. In reality, we came towards the left. We moved it this way, right? We made a smaller mask because we're trying to encompass more IP addresses, turning it into one. So we assigned to 22. Okay, so what's the summarized address? Because they're gonna ask you this in your CCNA and probably your network plus, okay? So the first two octets don't change, 192.168. 192.168. What? Well, what's on here? What is on in this area? Nothing. Okay, so that is your net ID. That equals net ID or your summarized address with the new mask. But let's work this out, okay? We got the line right here. This is the third octet, okay? So this is the net ID, what's the broadcast? 192.168.what? Okay, well, when you add these two, 1 and 2 is what? 3. 3 plus the 0 in the third octet is 3. What happened to the fourth octet? I said it was out there in the ether somewhere, right? It's off. But if you take the fourth octet and you add all its bit values, which is the same, it's 255. 255 plus that 0 right there, 255. That's your broadcast. I just want to put broad. Okay, so your range, right, would be, I'm just going to put the last two, okay? 0.1 to 3.254. What comes after 0.0? 0.1. What's before 3.255? 3.254. This is your range. So this should encompass 1, 2, and 3. Do we see a problem? Do we see an issue? Come on, think about it. Do we see an issue? Where did that zero come from? I didn't have the zero network here. So that's the rules that we did not follow in summarization, right? We have an even number of networks, and we start with an even number, okay? And they're contiguous. They're contiguous, but it's not an even number that we started with, and it's not an even number of networks. And that's why we have the zero network that snuck up on us. And listen, for testing purposes, it doesn't freaking matter. Whatever they ask you to summarize, you summarize. If they give you something like this, you know, they give you 4, 5, or 6, whatever it is, okay, you summarize it. That's it. That's your job, is to summarize it. Don't worry about anything else in a test, okay? And it's not going to be more than 4, okay? Maybe 6 if they just don't like you, okay? They'll give you more, but that's it. If you do it this way, and we're going to do one more. We're going to do one more, all right? But that's summarization. So let's follow the rules, shall we? Let's follow the rules. Let's erase this. So pause the video and see what I did, okay? So let me erase this. See, I got a good eraser right here. All right? Let me hurry up here. I know you're busy people. Okay? And somebody will say, hey, well, what about it? I'm going to give you a unique one, all right? I'm going to give you a very unique one that I got, okay, when I did my CCNA back in the Frank Flintstone era, okay? 100.12, 100.16, 100.20, and then 100.24. So, wow, you can't really see that. Okay. Let me see if I can make it bigger for you. Hold on. Give me a second. Right? It's been a second since I haven't been on the whiteboard. Okay. So let's write it out up here. 192.168. Let's put 1.12. 192.168 168.168.1.16.192.168.1.20.192.168.1.24. Cool. So now you got these addresses, and the way they're going to do it, or may do it, okay, is that you're going to look at a routing table. You're going to look at the routing table, and you're going to see the networks there. And then tell you, summarize the following networks. And then you have a snippet of the actual networks, okay? So you may say, well, what? We're working in the fourth octet because these three are the same. So they're not in contiguous order. Says who? They're incrementing by four, right? It's a CIDR 30, is it not? CIDR 30, you're incrementing by 4. 12, 16, 20, 24. It's a CIDR 30. All right? So let's write out our stuff here. Okay? So we got 128. Same format. 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. That is your last octet. That is the fourth octet. We are focused right here. We are focused in the fourth octet. Cool? Let's turn that into binary. 12. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. Let's see. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yep, I'm good. All right. 16. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. 20. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. And then 24. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. Let me see. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Yeah, we're good. Okay? I know I'm going off on a line, whatever. So, we do the same exact thing. This is our fourth octet. So, we're going to go from left to right and look for those uncommon bit values. So, they're all the same. They're all the same. You're all the same? Right there. So we went from a 30 to what? Well, 8 bits on, 8 bits on, 8 bits on. That's 24, 25, 26, 27. New mask is a CIDR 27. Yeah? There's nothing on this side. So what is the summary address? 192.168.1.0. Yeah? We have no choice. When you're in your certification, you have no choice. Okay? So there you go. Now let's say they give you this. Let's work it out. Let's see what addresses are in there. All right, cool. All right, so this is our net ID. We already got our line. So let's find out the broadcast. If you add all these guys up here, you get 31. Man, last can add fast. No, there's always one less that guy. So 31 plus 0, 192.168.1.31. That's your broadcast. Okay? And then what's in between? Well, what's after 1.0? 1.1. What's before 1.31? 1.30. There's your range. Are we having networks that are in there, they're not here? Sure. But in a certification, we do not care. If they tell you to summarize that, summarize it. That's it. Because the whole goal is to aggregate. It's to make the routing tables more efficient. Okay? That's the whole point. Because there's too many entries in the routing table, right? And we're not aggregating according to CCNP. We're not aggregating correctly. That's why they invented all this Lisp and all that stuff, okay? We need to do better summarization or more summarization or just plain old summarization. But again, there's different ways based on the routing protocol that you're using. So this is the concept of summarization right here. If you do it my way, as usual, if you do it my way, you can go ahead and do it quickly. So again, please, subscribe to the Networking Doctors YouTube channel. That helps me out so I can do more and more and more and more videos for you guys. All right? Hit the notification bell so as soon as I go live or I put in a new video, you'll get a notification. All right? And go to globed.net. I have these self-paced courses on there that I'm putting up. And when I have my boot camps coming up, like I have one coming up on February 3rd, all right, and I have workshops every single Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern time. So I do all this stuff, okay? This is the easy way of doing it. You do not have time to be doing physics in your exam. You should be able to do it in your fingers, okay? And you'll be good to go, all right? I'll see you guys in the next one.